Hey, what's up? It's that time of the year again. The best moments of the entire year is coming. Halloween! Ah! For me, it's one of my favorite times of the year. And because of that, I decided to create this video to let you guys know what I usually do with my contacts, because I use them a lot more around Halloween. And I want to give you guys some tips and tricks and safety concerns if you want to use contacts for Halloween this year, or if you just want to know more about them. So if you are interested, keep on watching. And if you like this video, don't forget to give it a big fat likey and subscribe if you want to see more of my face on your screen. So most of the contacts that I have are from Camo Eyes. I have been using these for about 3 years, I think. And that's almost as long as I've been doing Instagram and YouTube. Camo Eyes was also the first brand of contacts that I tried, and I immediately fell in love with them because they have such cool and awesome different designs. They go from natural contacts to really crazy contacts, and to contacts like this one, the white mesh. This is one of my favorite pairs. This is the one that I use in most of my makeup looks, because whatever you do with these contacts, it's always good. Your look always turns out twice as badass. And they just work. They just work with literally almost every look, except for your beauty, daily, whatever kind of look maybe. But that's something else. I own and I have owned quite a lot of their contacts in the past 3 years, and I've used them in a lot of my looks, as you can see. I used the White Manson contacts, I've used the Green Hulk contacts, I've used, obviously, like I said, the White Mesh contacts, I've used the Bullseye contacts. You can, of course, always edit your pictures when you put them on the Instagram and make your pictures look better. But if you also want to do videos, or if you just want to use them in real life and go to parties with them or whatever, it's better to use contacts, because that saves you a lot of work and it just looks pretty cool. Plus, they're pretty comfortable, actually. So here are a couple of things that I want to share with you guys if you do want to get some contacts for Halloween this year, or just for the sake of it, because you're a makeup artist or a makeup hobbyist, or you just like really cool contacts and you just want to use them. Because there are definitely some tips and tricks that I want to share, but there are also some safety concerns when it comes to this, because you have only two eyeballs, one pair of them, and you know, they're kind of important, you need them to see. So let's go over that first. So when you first receive your contacts, they probably come in a little bottle like this. They usually also have liquid in them. If they do not have liquid in them, then you cannot use the contact lens. Something has been broken and the liquid has slipped out, and then your lens has dried out and won't be usable again. So make sure to check for liquid in your little bottle. The liquid in this bottle is not contact lens solution. Do not put them in straight away. You will damage your eyes and hurt them, and it will not be a pleasant experience. So before you can actually put in your contact lenses, there's a couple of things you should do. First, you should get them out of this little bottle and put them in a contact lens case, such as this one. On little contact cases like this, there's usually an L and a R for left and right, or links and rechts, as we say in Dutch. So when you've put in your contacts for the first time, make sure to check in which case you're putting your contacts in, and make sure to not switch them. If you do switch them, it'll probably hurt your eye really bad. I don't know why exactly, but you cannot put your right contact in your left eyeball, so do not do that. Alright, so when you've put your contacts in your little contacts case, make sure to let them rest for about 4 to 6 hours so they can get used to the liquid, and just don't put them in before those hours. I would actually advise to let them rest overnight. So if you do get your contacts in the mail, I wouldn't suggest to put them in the same day. Just let them rest for a little bit and you'll have a bigger chance that they'll actually feel really nice in your eyes and that they will not hurt you. Putting in your contacts. This is the part where most people, including me, struggle with. It is very difficult to put in something inside your eyeball if you've never done it before, if you don't wear contact lenses. And it can get a little creepy because you're getting really up close and personal with your own eyeballs. And as humans, we tend to do this when something hits our eyeball. So if you want to get used to the feeling first, I would suggest to just try and lightly tap the white part of your eye. You can feel it, but you won't jump away and you won't get scared. And once you've gotten used to that feeling, you can actually try to put in your contact lenses. So before you put them in, make sure that your little hands are clean. Just wash them, towel them dry. Make sure there's not any grease, food, makeup or whatever on it left, because that can get into your contact lens, and if that'll get into your eye, it will hurt a lot and you will regret it. So do not do that. Keep your little hands clean. Once your hands are clean, just get one of your contacts out of the case. I always start with your right lens. Take out your lens very carefully. These are soft contact lenses. They can rip easily, and when they're ripped, they're done, they're dead, they're over. Once you've put out your contact lens, you can put it on your finger. Make sure to check if your lens is inside out. You can see it if the lens is curved up nicely and it looks like it actually fits onto your eyeball, it'll be good. If it is a little distorted or it's pointing downwards again at the sides of the contact lens, it's inside out. If you do put your contact lens in inside out, it will hurt a lot and you will immediately notice it. Your eye will start to tear up. Just get it out as soon as possible, because this is not good. So I'm just gonna show you guys how I put in my contact lens. My eye may be a little red because I just took it out. And to make sure that I don't jump away or get scared, I usually put it on the white part of my eye and then I'll push it towards the iris and it'll fall in place eventually. And just tap it a little to make sure that all the air bubbles get out. Blink. You can push it towards your iris if you want. And then it's secured. Okay, so for removing them, the process is pretty much the same. Do one eye at a time. And make sure that if you have long fingernails like I do, that you pull out your contact lens with these sides of your fingers. So do not try to grab and pinch your contact lens like this. Just try to take it out with the sides of your fingers. So I'm gonna get close to my mirror again. I'm gonna push my contact lens to the side so it's not on my iris anymore. And with the sides of my fingers, I'm gonna try and get it out. Ta-da! Caring for your contacts is also very important. Once again, they go in your eyeballs. Eyeballs are important, which means that contacts are important. So when you're putting them back in their little contact case, always make sure to put a little contact lens solution on your hands. Clean your contact lens a little to make sure that any dirt from your eye does not get back into the contact lens case. And always fill your contact lens case with fresh contact lens solution. So get out the old stuff first, put in some new fresh contact lens solution, then put your contact lens in it, and screw on the top. And your contact lenses need this liquid to stay fresh and to make sure that they're all like hygienic, don't get any infections or bacteria in it. And like anything else, you need to care for them. So I don't know how often you plan to wear them. I do not wear all of mine very often, so every few weeks, maybe once a month, I open all of them and I put some extra contact lens solution in them to make sure that they stay hydrated and that they don't dry out. Because when they do dry out, they start to crack and break. All this types of little gunk comes on them, and you can pretty much say goodbye to them when they're completely dried out, because it's not entirely safe to put them back into your eyes again. And like anything else, contacts have an expiration date. This depends on the type of contact that you buy. Usually the cheaper ones are also for a shorter period. You have day contacts, 3 month contacts, 1 year contacts. I think that these are the ones that you will encounter the most. Maybe if they're custom made, they will last you longer, I can't say for sure. Have I worn my contacts longer than the expiration date? Yes, I have. Would I recommend to do it? No, do it at your own risk. I just usually check if they're still comfortable, if they look good, if there's not anything weird on them. And if they actually look and feel good, I will wear them a little bit longer than the expiration date. But I have thrown out contacts that I've owned for, well, quite a long time. So here are some last tips for wearing these awesome contact lenses. Do not share them with friends. If you do like a thing that both of you guys are wearing one contact lens, that's nice, but throw them away afterward, because you do not want your friend's bacteria in your eye. You can get infections, your iris can tear, you can get all kinds of diseases. People have had to amputate their eyes because of this, so do not do that. Do not buy cheap contact lenses that come from AliExpress, eBay, anything sketchy. If they're about 10 euros, then they're probably crap unless they're day contacts. So make sure if you buy contact lenses online or in store that you validate if the store is actually legit, if they have good reviews, and if those contact lenses are FDA approved. That's all very important for the safety of your eyes. I know that if you're wearing them for Halloween, it's just for one day, it's just for one party, but it only takes one day for your eye to develop some kind of nasty disease, and you don't want to do that, now do you? If you're planning to wear your contact lenses for a longer period, say a Halloween party or a night or any kind of other events, do not buy contact lenses and then put them in for 8 hours a day and just go to the party and party hard until you die because your eyes are not having a good time. If you're planning to wear contact lenses for a longer period, make sure to build that up. So let's say a week in advance, start wearing them for maybe half an hour, then the next day an hour, the day after that 2 hours. So your eyes can get used to the feeling of them and to wear them for a longer period. So make sure to build it up and keep that in mind before you go anywhere. And always, always keep them clean, keep your hands clean, keep the contact cases clean. And do not wear them if they hurt, if they're broken, or if the dye is going all places where it should not be. Only wear them if they're completely safe, if they look good, if they feel good, and if nothing else is bothering you.